Excuse me. I'm late for church because I'm tired. I don't come to church because I'm tired, because I've worked so hard trying to be what need be, and I'm allowing my own self to hinder me from doing what God has called me to do because I am broken. Because somebody across the aisle helped break you. Oh God, help me, Jesus. Don't look away. Somebody with your same last name helped break you. Hallelujah. Somebody that came out of the same room you came out helped break you. Am I in the right church? Talk back to me and let me know I'm in the right church. Somebody that you came out helped break. Get around together. And because of what they get, somebody I trusted. Am I in the right church? I gotta know somebody I trusted. A man or a woman of God broke me. Somebody I fed at my table helped break me.
All right, Bishop. All right.
Somebody I was faithful to helped break me. My mama broke me. Oh, am I in the right church? My daddy broke me. And because of the brokenness, the brokenness on the inside. It's not giving giving you a reason, but I'm going to explain to you. That's why I'm so hateful, because I'm broken. Somebody say amen real good. Amen. Y'all talk to me. I cut you off because I was broken. The reason I rolled my eyes is because I'm broken. The reason why I talk so much, because so many people told me to shut up at one time, and I felt like I didn't have a voice. So now I'm talking about everything I can talk about just so I can be heard. You want to know why I'm so loud? Because I need to be heard, because I was. Some of us in here have been through domestic abuse. You love that man, yes you do.
Jesus.
You love that man so much, your children look just like him.
Jesus.
That's how much you loved him. But that same man you love, put his hand around your throat, and you saw your life. You saw somebody else raising your children. But you came to church like everything was all right. Am I in the right church? Hey. And you're broken. Preaching and broken. Staying and broken. Things you never experience, and if you ain't experiencing, I'm only experiencing my revelation. But one of the worst things you can ever experience is when you lost your mother.
Jesus.
For those of us that ain't lost your mama yet, this is what happens when you lost your mother. When you was in the womb, when you was in your mother's womb, there was a connection from your mother to your navel. Forever, as long as you live, even though they cut the cord, there's still a connection that holds you. But when your mama dies, you feel like you're floating and you don't know how to stop falling. Amen.
Yes.
And some of you right now are still missing your mama, and you're broken.
Yes.
My God. You feel like you can't breathe. The second you find out your mama is gone, you feel like you can't breathe. For a split second, you want to die yourself because mama is gone. The Bible tells me, that when mother and father forsake you, one day mama will have to leave you. Not because she wanted to, but because she had to. And in the midst of all of that, some of you, when your mama died, you were so out of control of your emotions, you couldn't even cry. You felt bad because tears couldn't flow.
Yes.
Am I in the right church?
Yes,
I'm broken.
Yes, you are.
We have a church full. When man makes something, if man builds a house, or if man make a cake, or if man makes anything, the quality of the cake, or the quality of the house, or the quality of the dress that they make, or the suit that they make, is based upon the quality of the material.
Yes.
Only God can take broken pieces and still make something worthy of his honor. Oh, Lord. And I don't care how broken the church is, we are still the church of the living God.
Yes.
We are a broken church. The Spirit of the Lord upon me. Hey God. Because he had anointed me to preach what? The gospel. Oh glory. God has anointed us to preach this gospel. I know the devil been fighting you, but he's been fighting you for you to, so you can deny the power of your brokenness. Can we say this? Can you say this to me? Say, there's power in my brokenness. No matter how broken I am, God is still going to use me. Can you clap your hands because you believe it? Broken.
Thank you, Lord.
Broken. There's the least favor you right now that the devil calls you to go through so much trauma in your childhood that you ought to be crazy. That's folk in this room right now that don't know, nobody else in this room know your story, but God knows your story. God knows your story. And I come to you to tell you and to prophesy to you that what God is going to use, he's going to use your brokenness for ministry. Can I say it like this? He can't use you until you are broken. Can I say that again? That's why we need to stop praying, use me, Lord. Because if you tell him to use you, he's going to break you.
He's
going to
break
you. He's going to break you. He can't use you until he breaks you. My God, he got to break me. Many are the afflictions of the righteous. But every time he breaks me, he's only positioning me to use me. I'm going to say it again, every time he breaks, he's only me to use me. Every time he broke me, he's only positioning me to use me. So he broke me on purpose. He broke me with an intention to use me. Oh God, he broke me with an intention to use me. Hallelujah. And you know what? I gotta stop praising God for all the people God used to help to break me. I gotta stop being mad. I gotta stop being hurt. I gotta stop having my feelings on my sleeve. Because God used them to break me. He used them. They lied, but God used the lie for his glory. They and said all this stuff about me, but they don't realize God was only setting me up to use me for His glory. Oh God, help me. This is my thing, is this, that the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but they're mighty through God. For the pulling down of strongholds. Where are the strongholds? The strongholds are in our minds. So when I pull down the strongholds, I am changing the way I let the brokenness affect me. See, what you gotta understand, the devil thinks it's going to destroy you, but if you use your weapons, God will get the glory out of your brokenness. Oh God, help me, Jesus. I hear a shaking in this chest right now. I hear a shaking in here right now. Even while I'm talking, God is healing your brokenness.
Yes,
Lord. Thank you, Lord. I don't care if they like me, I'm still going to love them. Can I say it again? I don't care if they don't like me, I'm still going to love them. I don't care what they've done to me in the past. I already forgive them before they even done it. I thought God showed me this last week. Here we got Jesus hanging on the cross and his Father forgive them, for they know not what they do. Jesus hanging on the cross. The hands they used to slap him with, he made those hands. But he says, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. The whips that they used to beat him with, he created the whip to be beaten with. But he says, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. Oh, God, even the spit that they used to spit in his face, God gave them that spit. He says, Father, forgive them, but they know not what they do. Why am I sitting around here not being like Jesus? So that's the Lord, give me power to forgive them. They've done me wrong. Give me power that I understand. If they had not broken me, I could never be resurrected. If they had broken me, I could never get up out the grave. So I thank you for breaking me, so I can be resurrected.
Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you.
And so us don't understand this, and y'all ain't gonna understand this until I explain it to you. We don't understand some of the people that we are not forgiving are holding us hostage. Y'all ain't gonna like it. They're holding us hostage. We can't go any farther because we're still holding on to what they've done to us. But I tell you, let it go. You know why? We don't understand forgiveness. We think forgiveness saying it's all right what you're doing. It's all right. It's all right. Just do it again. Do it again. I remember my great grandmother. She said when she first got saved, they preached about taking off a cheek. They said when she first got saved, she'll hold her face out and they'll smack in the face. She'll turn the other cheek and they'll smack in their face. And so all the day long, all the other children in the community, they'll see smack. The devil ain't called me for everybody to keep slapping me in my face.
That's amen. Right.
We'll
do it.
Thank you, Jesus. We'll do it. He didn't call me. But he called me to this point. That if God tells me to let them smack me in my face, I'm going to hold my face out. But God ain't told me that nobody stab me in my face unless I'm going to get some millions of dollars for it. Amen. God told me. So forgiveness is this. Y'all keep this definition. Forgiveness is this. whatever God tell me to do concerning you, I obey God in doing it. Do I have to go to your house every day? No.
That's right.
Do I gotta fry you some chicken and drink some Kool-Aid? No. But what do I have to do is, God, I will obey you and whatever you tell me to do for that person. Jesus says, Father, forgive them, for they know not what to do. I don't like what they're doing to me right now, but God, I'm still going to obey you and die on the cross for their sins. I'm still going to obey you. I do what you told me to do. Forgiveness is not being a fool. It is still obeying God regardless.
Yes.
All of us are just wrestling with this.
Yes.
Hey, y'all give me 5 or 10 more minutes, I'm with you. All of us wrestle with this. All of us wrestle with this. You got a thought process. Have you ever walked through the house and you forgot about something? And you walk through the house and the devil brings something back to your mind or something somebody done to you.
Uh-huh.
And you walk through the house and you don't want to have a good day and that evil. So I can keep my spirit in the right place. Because I understand if I hold on to what they've done to me, it's going to hinder me from going to my next level. And that little racket behind ain't worth me missing what God has for me. Lord, help me, Jesus. You look it up. Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
You look real nice today.
You look real nice today.
Say, but your raggedy behind ain't worth me missing my next victory in God. You better praise him because your victory is on the way. Oh, that was cute. If I told you had a new car coming, then you better praise him because your victory is on his way. I let it go. I forgive you. And you know what? That's another thing. The opposite side of that is, I let anybody hold me hostage under the spirit of offense. What's that? That is people that you have offended. They sitting around here offended because of you. And they sitting around holding you hostage because they mad at you. And so what you gotta pray, you gotta say, Father, release me from every spirit of offense. Somebody pray that and say, Lord, release me from every spirit of offense. And this is what you gotta do right here. You gotta be willing that if somebody come to you and say you offended me, don't give no explanation. Don't say if I offended you. Say because I offended you, I ask you to forgive me. It's a demon.
Yes, it is.
It's a demon.
Yes, it is.
You don't understand this.
Yes, it is.
Demons have to have entryways. All of us in here, you can. I think it's 3 doors inside this church. Everybody here came in a door. Only thieves come through windows.
All right, Bishop.
But all of us here came through doors. You walked up in here and through a door.
Yes,
you stepped up in this place through a door.
Yes,
when you walk around in the spirit of offense, it's opening up the door for demons to enter in. So you ain't got time. That's why I ain't got time to be walking around either offended or offended somebody else. I gotta walk around in the mountains. So, if you offended me, I forgive you.
I know that's right.
If I offended you, I'm sorry. I ain't got time for it. Forgiveness and being offended holds us hostage to our brokenness. That's why you can't get over it. You can shout, oh. You can have hands laid on it. Oh. You can come to church and work, oh. But you're still broken.
Yes, God.
Can I tell you something? I'm almost through. Can I tell you something? Majority of us, and y'all hear me real good, and I hope my mic don't go out when I'm saying this, but y'all gotta hear me. The majority of us gotta be real with ourselves. You've been broken too long. You've been broken too long. You know why you go to sleep and sleep all night and you're still tired? You know why you're going to sleep and sleep all night because you're still tired? Because in your sleep, you're fighting the brokenness.
Yes.
But I come to Pentecost to release my brokenness at Pentecost. My God.
Yes, God. Yes, God.
Hey. Hey, I come to release the brokenness of my conception. Some of you in here was products of growing up without fathers. That's automatic brokenness right there. Some of you didn't have a mama. That's automatic brokenness right there. Some of you were rejected by your mother and your father. Brokenness. Some of you went through broken relationships. Don't nobody know what you went through because you hear all the brokenness in your family. They don't understand you, and that's why your next relationship is hard for you to learn how to get together. It's because you're still fighting your own self and the old you.
My God.
Can I be deep real quick?
Yes.
Can I get in? Don't nobody be offended. And I'm going to walk my 5 minutes. I'm already going 5 minutes. Every man or woman that you have, and y'all grown folks get this, have had relations with, unless you get them out of your spirit, you're still carrying that baggage. So many of you right now sitting up here, you got an ex-husband, and he's still sitting right down on your soul. Oh, y'all are quiet on me. Your ex-wife still sitting right there. She's still sitting right down in your soul, and you can't get no victory. Get it out. I don't even talk about marriage. Your ex-boyfriend or your baby daddy is still sitting right down your soul. And you're carrying them.
Jesus.
And you can't even enjoy the new relationship because you still carry the old.
Jesus.
You can't even go any farther because you still carry the old. There is no space for the new. Oh, I need 4 minutes and we're going to pray for you. God has called us out of brokenness. He says, I give you beauty for ashes. What is ashes? Ashes is when the wood been through the fire. And it's broken down so far, hallelujah, that man can't put it back together again. I sit in a church with some people, but all you got left in your soul is some emotions. All you got left in your soul is some ashes. But I say the kind of God of my nation that can breathe the ashes back together again. Somebody right there in this sanctuary, they say, Bishop, And Bishop is preaching right to me. He ain't preaching nobody but me today. But I want you to prove them wrong. I want every person in this room that has experienced brokenness to stand to their feet. I want only the broken people to stand. My God.
Jesus.
Only the broken.
Yes, Lord.
The thing
yes,
about
Lord.
Being broken, it ain't got no age limit. And don't judge, just I don't know why they standing. They ain't been through nothing. You don't know what I've been through.
Amen. That's right.
All you know is the me I show you. You don't know the me that I don't show you.
That's right.
You don't know the me when I don't show you. Broken. In this room to lift up your hands unto God. Half mass broken. All of the broken people lift up their hands. Because the healer is here. The healer is here.